Do you think you know everything about HACS, one of the most popular home assistant integration? We're going to find out today if you can answer these 5 HACS/home assistant questions, each featuring different HACS or home assistant aspect. Your knowledge is amazing. And if you are an OG home assistant and HACS user and you're watching this video thinking, I'll definitely get 5 out of 5, don't be so sure, some new learners might get a better score than you. And before we begin, I want to remind you that I've made a smart home glossary PDF and you can download it for free. It is full of smart home words and acronyms and their simple explanation, so you can always check their meaning if you forget something and ultimately to memorize it for life. If you want to download the PDF, all you have to do is click the link in the description box or follow this link or scan the QR code. Then you enter your name and your email address, you sign up for my mailing list and the PDF will arrive directly in your inbox. After that, you've joined my free newsletter club, you automatically receive my weekly articles and news. It is a free service and you can unsubscribe at any time with just one click. Okay, let's start with number 1. This one is relatively easy. What HACS stands for? I'll give you 5 seconds. HACS stands for Home Assistant Community Store and it is a free and open source project that is not selling anything despite that store word in the name. It serves as a hub for community members who want something custom for Home Assistant, like custom integrations, themes, cards, and more. Let's look at question 2. How can you backup your HACS? I'll give you 5 seconds. And the answer is, HACS is included in the regular Home Assistant backup process, so you don't have to do nothing more. Did you get that? However, to ensure you can recover your setup if necessary, don't forget to regularly backup Home Assistant and securely store the backups in a safe location outside of your Home Assistant instance. Also, please do a backup before trying to install HACS. That way, if something goes totally wrong, you'll be on the safe side. Okay, question 3. On which Home Assistant installation types can HACS be installed? Home Assistant OS, Home Assistant Container, Home Assistant Supervised, Home Assistant Core. I'll give you 5 seconds again. And the answer is all. HACS can be installed on every supported Home Assistant installation. Let me explain. There are 4 official and supported methods to get Home Assistant. And while the core is the same on all of them, the installation steps differ. And not only that, some of them are using Docker, other Python, some have add-ons inside where the others don't, and I have a free Home Assistant webinar which I'm talking exactly about that. What are the pros and cons of the different Home Assistant installation types? And right now you can attend that webinar for free by clicking the link in the video description or by follow this link, or if you wish you can scan that QR code. Back to HACS installation. If you open hacs.xyz, which is the official HACS website, and if you go to the downloading HACS section, you'll be able to select a tab that matches your Home Assistant installation type. Inside these tabs, you'll find detailed instructions on how to install HACS, where Home Assistant OS and supervised HACS installation is the same, and we also have container and core sections. Following these instructions, you'll have HACS in no time. And once again, HACS can be installed on all Home Assistant installation types. Did you get that right? We are a little above halfway through the video. How many of the questions have you got right so far? Is anyone having a 3 out of 3? Here is question 4. Do you have to visit HACS section in Home Assistant to check for updates? I'll give you some thinking time. And the answer is no. HACS updates, as well as updates for custom components installed through HACS, will now be shown where all Home Assistant updates are usually displayed. Even more, after the updates are complete, you also receive suggested action or so-called repairs, such as reload your dashboards or reboot Home Assistant. That question was a bit tricky because before HACS version 2, that was released a few days ago, you actually have to open HACS section to check for updates, and they were not automatically visible for you before. But now this is not the case anymore. Alright, we are on number 5, my final question. Can HACS install Home Assistant add-ons? Have your seconds? The answer is no. This appears to be one very common misunderstanding because HACS is an integration, not an add-on, and it does not manage add-ons. So, HACS and add-ons are completely different and unrelated things. However, add-ons are available inside Home Assistant OS and supervised, which have their own built-in store. So if you want add-ons, you can find them there. HACS, on the other hand, installs custom code that runs within Home Assistant, which in theory can impact your system stability. So again, don't forget to backup before any major or even minor change. Okay, so how many of those things did you know? Let me know your score out of 5 in the comments. If you answered all of those questions correctly, well done, your HACS knowledge is truly impressive. I'm Kirill and I'll see you soon for another video. Bye!
Yeah, Yeti!